So welcome back to episode 7 of Dark Souls, and we're just taking off from the blacksmith here. We're gonna go grab a few items from the forest. Oh god, go away! That I wanted. I did not expect him to be able to reach me there. Oh well, I have the health to tank it. So there's the couple items that I want are the Elite Knight set of armor, and the Grass Crest Shield, and if I can, I'll go take on Havel and get Havel's Ring. And that will be a very excellent combination of stuff. And then I can just Homeward Bone out of this entire area. I think I got a few of those. Yeah, I got 6. I'm good. I got more than enough for what I need. So, running here, that's the Door of Artorias. There's an illusionary wall there, but I can't stop there now. And I want a Homeward Bone out of here, so I can't rest right now. So we'll go through this fog wall. With all of these trees are chasing me. And we're gonna go over here to the right and be like, ooh, pretty. And grab this. And it's like, oh no! Ah, run! It's a trap, but I got away so easily. And since I'm here, I'll go fight the butterfly. I mean, I'm here anyway. Might as well. I'm getting so distracted and going down in the depths. I'm just like, oh, but I could do this. Oh, but I could do that. And this is the Moonlight Butterfly. Actually, a very sort of beautiful boss, I'd have to say. And pretty relaxing, in my opinion. It's got, about 4 or 5 attacks. It all depends on the particle that it shoots. So let's see. That one, you just have to tank. There's no dodging it, really. Yeah, but if you get into the right position, you can dodge it. This one, you have to dodge. Otherwise, it will just do crap tons of damage to you. What's this one? Yeah. Just gotta tank that one a little bit. Ow, ow. God damn it. Come on, Monsieur Butterfly. Land. But if you're just in the right position, you can dodge it a little while. So dodge a little bit of it. The slow one, you just wait until it's really close to you and then dodge. Preferably dodging away from the direction it's traveling. So if you're off to one side, dodging to the other side works well for it. But eventually, it's going to land. Excellent. And I can just wail on it. And hopefully get a bleed on it. But just wail on it for as long as you can, as fast as you can, and as soon as you start to see it charge up, back off. As that attack there does a significant amount of damage. You can also attack it when it's in the air here with spells and with arrows and stuff, and there is an NPC summon that you can do for this place called Witch Beatrice or whatever. I can't remember her name. But she makes this fairly easy because she's DPSing the thing the entire time. But now we'll just wait and watch. Oh, and it goes over. Typically throws down a bomb of some kind. Nope, didn't do it that time. If you're underneath it, it sort of bombs you as it goes over. And it hasn't done its laser move yet, which is kind of funny. Come on, do your Kamehameha. Or land, how about? That's a good time to chug. Come on. Land, please? Thank you. We're gonna try Pyromancy now. So that's doing a fair amount of damage. Burn, butterfly, burn! And I got it now. It's going to keep attacking as I will kill it before the explosion goes off. And as long as the thing's dead, that explosion won't do any damage. But we have the soul of the Moonlight Butterfly. We can head up here. Do, 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 do. This is an entirely optional boss, but it does get you a really cool item, which is important for faith builds. It's the Divine Ember from this sort of petrified blacksmith here. You get the Watchtower Basement Key and the Divine Ember and a Homeward Bone. And the Divine Ember allows you to take a +5 weapon and take it to Divine. And that can level up a weapon so that it's running off your faith stat instead of your other stats. I mean, it still will run off your strength and dexterity, all weapons do, but it will have a much higher scaler off of your faith stat. So we're just going to run out of here because I don't want a Homeward Bone all the way back to Firelink at this moment. It's not what I need. And we're going to... One second here as I check something. Okay, we're going to go and we're going to go get the Grass Crest Shield, and then we're going to take on... Torius, and these guys are annoying as heck. Can you guys come in so I can get by you? Thank you. Ow. Can I get out of here? Thank you. And we're just gonna run along here and get the heck out of here. Take a second to chug and keep running. And the Grass Crest Shield is so important that I'm doing this divergence for, is it gives you stamina regeneration. And that is absolutely amazing. Like, God, I love stamina regen. It just makes life so much better. And I will do a proper, I'll go through this entire place in the future. Because there's a whole bunch of items I'm just running by. I'll come back here and do this area proper when I go and do the other part of the forest as well. So don't worry about that. But it is just down to the left here. And there's actually something we have to be a little bit cautious of. Is the fact that there's a crystal lizard just down here. So we have to make sure we get that lizard. And I might use Pyromancy for him. Because Pyromancy's a little easy to shoot. So there he is, right there. So, he's difficult and you have to pay attention because he's below you on an incline. And what that does is it makes it really hard to hit him, so you actually have to walk by him and attack back. Oh, I missed him! God damn it. That one's hard to get unless you're, like, right on top of him. You can actually come through this place from the other way, but, oh well. I missed him. If I reset the game, I can get another chance at him. There's a pile of leather equipment and a bow there, which may come in useful. May come in handy later. We're just going to take out our sword, and we're going to go and stab Havel in the back, and then Homeward Bone back to Firelink, and head down into the depths, finally. All this preparation. It's kind of funny. I always have this sort of, like... This is how I want to build my characters and all these sort of scavenger hunts that I do when I start off. And there's Havel right there. So I have all these scavenger hunts, and it's just kind of funny. It just takes a while of going back and forth, and there's a sequence to things. And eventually, I get there. Eventually I'll get my stuff that I want to use. I pretty much have it by now, my sort of equipment I will use for my final stuff, and I can just upgrade it from there. But we're just circling Havel, we're waiting for him to make the first attack, and he does, and we just backstab. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. And we'll just repeat. Attacks, we backstab. And I'm doing 90, that's enough. It's gonna take a few backstabs to get him, but... Whoop! We'll get him eventually. We could also try the Pyromancy on him. Havel? You okay? Come here. Attack me, baby. Come on. Swing. Oh no, that's 34 damage. We're not doing that. Back to sword. I might even try to flick into the two-hand of the sword when I see him do his swing. So flick. Oh, that was the wrong thing to do. chug, chug, dodge. Oh my god. Okay. Almost died, but survived. Nope. Fuck you, Havel. Fuck you. Yeah, this guy can hit like a truck when he wants to. But backstabs are a thing. Whew. And if I am good, you can chain backstabs a little bit with this guy. If you're good. But it's a little difficult to do. Just gotta wait till he stands up and be in the right spot to get a chain backstab. But I missed it. Just going to continue to work him down like this. Just need to do that maybe about 4 times. Yep, it's going well. The reward for this guy is amazing. Come on. Okay, get away from the wall. It sucks when I can't maneuver around you that easily. Come on, come on, come on. Wasn't a backstab. Neither was that. Whoa. Oh god. We can also back out of here if I need to. I'll pop a humanity to heal. And he's not gonna regenerate, which is a very good thing. If this guy chugged Estus, it would be a sad, sad encounter. Come on. Come on. Good little apple. One more. One more. No! Don't hit me. Goodbye! Yes! Havel is down. And we get the Havel's ring. And why I wanted this ring so badly is if we look at our equip load and it goes from 73 to 109. What? You can get so much equip load with this, and now we can switch into this Elite Knight's gear, which is the stuff I want to eventually use. So I can start to get a little bit of actual armor. What a concept! And we get the Elite Knight armor, and we can go to the Grass Crest Shield that is somewhere around here. Oh, I haven't picked that up yet. Alright, I go get the Grass Crest Shield, and then I'm done down here. Too much weight in the Elite Knight's armor. I'll have to just keep on the Wanderer's coat. But we got the leggings and the gloves on. It's good enough for now. Last thing is a Grass Crest Shield, which is just down here to the side. And we'll take out the Black Knight that's here. That will give us... Hey, maybe he'll drop a Black Knight weapon. That is always a good thing to get. Run. And I also have 16,000 souls to spend. Woo! That's awesome. Come down here. Hey, look, it's a Black Knight. He doesn't hit as hard as Havel, but he is still a pain in the ass. There's actually kind of a glitchy camera there. There's a really easy way to get rid of these guys, is you can... Because you kick them so far when you backstab them. You can actually kick him off the edge, and a lot of speedrunners use that so that they can kill this guy with one hit, even if they're level 1. And I'll probably show that in my next playthrough. I'll come through in the way that you would speedrun it. One more. He's down. Excellent. I got a blue Titanite chunk. I didn't get his weapon, though. If you were speedrunning, you'd reset. And this is the Pillage Corpse for the Grass Crest Shield. And this shield is amazing. While it only has 95% physical, it's better for magic and fire. And it has the secondary effect. As you can see that green glowing around me now, that my stamina is going to recharge faster. So if I attack here and lower my stamina all the way, my stamina bar is coming back much faster than before. So excellent, we will return to the last bonfire rested at, which should be the, should be Firelink. And we will get our 10 Estus, and we will level up here. again, putting some more into endurance so I can level up that equip load so I can carry more armor, which is the most important thing. Stats are one thing, but mainly it's equipment that does your damage, so going for the ability to wear more equipment is more important than otherwise. I could almost mid-roll, fast roll, maybe, in this, pyromancy flame weighs nothing. Oh, sure, I'll just leave it on then. So I can maybe put that on, maybe take the gloves off. Ah, there we go. So now I got the Elite Knight chest piece. Oh, now my character's feeling, like I'm used to. And another thing that the Elite Knight set, or at least the fact that we have an armor set that actually has some armor to it, and it's not just leather, like the Wanderer set, is that it has poise. And poise is a really good thing to have, because poise is kind of like an invisible meter of how many hits you can take before you get stunned. So if you have a bunch of poise, you can basically continue your attack animations and such through enemy attacks. Or if you have no poise, any enemy attack will knock you out of an attack animation. But now we can head down into the depths and continue through the depths all the way to Blighttown and beyond. And we will not return back to Firelink for at least 3 boss battles. Take out these guys. Easy peasy. There's a guy right here that we just drop onto. Dink. There. Ow! Ow! See, that's the attack that does a lot of damage from these guys. That's the one you want to watch out for. I'm just going to put myself behind here so that he runs into that because of his pathing. Thankfully, he's a bit dumb. Head down. Ooh, there's another one to get. I have a little bit longer reach than you. I'll just top up. I got lots of Estus. And we've gotten this chest here, but there actually is another little secret right here, and that is this passageway. And you may think, like, oh, it's a dark and, like, scary passageway to drop down, but actually it's completely fine. And you can get a shield this way, and you can actually get through the level. Like, I could be through the level and fighting the boss within the next 30 seconds if I went this way and ran, but that's no fun. You guys want to see the whole game now, don't you? Which is why I will go back to that forest area and do a proper play of that section. I just wanted these items so badly that I ran through. Ow! Stop nibbling on my cankles. Oh my god, they're so agile in this murky water. And I... Oh my god. I gotta get out of this water. I gotta get a heal off behind the pillar for a little bit of cover and get the heals off. Got the 2 dogs. Excellent. Oh, that was annoying. Dogs are so annoying when your mobility is screwed. I can actually show something off here. There's a few places in the game where your mobility is lowered like this. And if you are sprinting, your stamina goes down, but if you constantly swap your shield, your stamina actually regenerates a very small amount. It's really weird. It's like they have a rounding system, and every time you swap out, you get rounded back up to the last number. So, you can save a little stamina that way. But we're gonna fight this person now. Normally you'd be facing the other way when this person drops, and so you'd all of a sudden get somebody coming in behind you. But I know where this person comes from, so I can watch from the front. Ow. That hurts. And take it up the butt. Ooh, I got a bleed off. See how that did a whole bunch of damage? It's because I attacked in a quick enough succession that I got a bleed. A sack! What a concept. Where's that sack? Oh, I'm styling. Ass. But no, that looks weird. I'll put on the thief mask. Oh, that probably looks pretty. Yeah, that looks fine. Yeah, there you go. Maybe I can get on the black leather gloves. Yeah, I'm still fast rolling. Sweet. No, I look awesome. We've already rescued the pyromancer guy, so we can just head down this way and head down into the depths. And here's another little training thing they do, where they're like, ooh, treasure. But there's a bastard on the ceiling there, which you can't target onto yet. So you go, ooh, treasure, and come this way, but then guy jumps on your face and starts eating your face. And there's like, oh no, it's gonna eat my face. And you just barely survive. And they specifically design that encounters that you do, or at least hopefully you do, you don't go down there with zero health. And so that you can learn the fact that these guys exist, and what they do, and how they attack you, which is to drop from the ceiling. And these guys are super easy to take out otherwise. I didn't get the soldier. And so now they're going like, okay, we've taught you how to do this, now continue it. And as you move into the next areas, now you've got to be cautious, looking up and going, oh, is there an enemy up here that could get me? I don't know. So you can see up on the roof there that there's multiple guys along here. So you can sort of use that as your guide and go, okay, now I want to go over here, now over here, now I want to go through these guys. Ah, and I got through them without getting caught. And these guys don't really give enough souls to matter fighting, so I'm not going to. And if you took the master key, you can open this door, and there's a bonfire. Never fear, you can actually get to this bonfire completely without the master key, but it involves you going further into, oh, what's the hell? I can't light it. Oh, am I getting invaded? Oh, that'd be something. Oh? Strange. It involves you going further into the depths and finding a key and then coming back. So, you can do it, but it just takes longer. And for some reason, I can't light that bonfire. Oh, it might have been because this guy was too close. That might have been it. Took him out. Can I light it now? No. I can summon somebody. Some random player. I don't need that yet. I just need to rest. It's probably because these guys are too close, because the "you are being invaded" hasn't shown up yet. Yes! Large Titanite Shard! Oh, but I'm... I don't want to go back to the bonfire. I probably should, though. Ah, oh, the bonfire's right here! But... I want to backtrack again! Okay, for this one, I am going to edit it out, because I'm just going to go back to the blacksmith. Now that I have a large Titanite Shard, I can change my weapon from +5 to +6, and then I can't do that. I can't modify it, but the blacksmith can. But what I can do in the future is I can change my stuff from +6 all the way to +10 with just large Titanite Shards, and I'm going to get them down here in the depths in Blighttown, and I want to be able to do that reinforcing while I'm away from the blacksmith. So, okay, I'm going to edit this out, but I'm just going to pop over to the blacksmith real quick and do that, and I'll pick back up when I get back to this position. Alright, we're back. Well, I'm back. Those guys tried to eat me, but I'm here. I've upgraded my Uchikatana to +6 now. I've sort of ascended it to its next stage. And hopefully, I can get down here and rest at this goddamn bonfire. Light? There we go. Something was bugged with this, and I can rest. Oh, I can put a point into endurance. So now I got all of my different boxes here. I can reinforce my weapon. And I can upgrade my Uchikatana all the way to +10 while I'm here. I can also reinforce my armor, and I can start to work on my elite knight armor. Woo! Get those points. Oh, wow. There is a a very, very meta person here. Wanting to get summoned. Unfortunately, we're not going to summon any players, because I don't really want to summon some players. They're just going to blast through content probably too quickly, because I would like to show off. So we're just going to head down here, and wow, look at that rat. That is a huge, disgusting rat. You can go down here, and there is a ladder, which takes you to a door, which Master Key won't open. You actually need another... you need to go around and open from the other side. It's one of those, you don't need a key for it, you just need to get to the other side to get around. And that, remember up where I got the large ember, and there was that chest there, and I said, oh, you could go down this little hole, and you could get to the boss really quickly. That hole basically drops you into this room with this rat here, and you can do a jumping attack and plunge into the rat and do an awesome bit of damage to him, and then you can really easily get to the end boss that way. But oh my god, so many rats. Thankfully, I one-shot them, so they're a little bit easier, because I only have to worry about getting one attack in. And the Great Axe. It's a decent strength weapon. Well, strength isn't my playstyle in this game, but... You gotta keep your guard up at all times, because you never know when things might jump out at you. And of course I knew that was coming. I played this game far too much. No, get back here, rat. These guys aren't that terribly hard at this stage. You can grab this through. And that's the sewer chamber key. So that's the key that allowed you, if you wanted to, go back up and open where that bonfire was. So normally you'd have to come to this point and then go back up. But because I had the master key, I could do it a bit earlier. You can go down this route here, and you can chase after that rat, but be careful as that's a hole there. We're not going to go down this way yet. We will go down it later, but no, we want to go this way first. Because there's a very, very important person to kill over here, so that they don't absolutely screw up your boss fight. Kind of hard to see. There are three big rats and a channeler. Just like in the top of the Undead Parish there, he's going to shoot magic, and he's going to do his little dance here, and he is going to buff these three rats with some an attack aura that increases their damage. And thankfully, I just aggroed one of the rats, so I can take them out piecemeal instead of all at once. But they're a two-hit kill for me, so they require that little bit more time when you're fighting them. Channeler's coming up next. It's great. Come here, Channeler. I can dodge your magic all day. And we just lay into him, and he goes down fairly easily. Just these rats, they have just such high attack numbers with that aura on them that they're a little scary. Just gotta take care of them cautiously and keep your shield up. Excellent. And if you learned anything from earlier, you remember, keep your shield up at all times, because there could be surprises waiting around the corner. But nothing in these ones here. And that there is actually the boss room, which we will be down very shortly. I'll probably do this episode just exploring this entire area, grabbing some items from the lower area, and then go fight the boss. This way, we can chase down this bad guy here. He sort of walks right over this. Oh, there he goes down that hole. We don't want to go down the hole yet. To explore a little bit further. There's a slime here, which we can just take care of. I think combustion's actually fairly powerful. Oh yeah, combustion's amazing against these guys. And you want to be careful, as there's another hole right there. So this is not the way you want to go. And then double back. You want to turn... here. We'll take out this rat. this treasure. And this is leading us into the big rat room. So this guy is aggressive as heck. And he is fast for his size. Wow! Jesus. So we're gonna have to be a little cautious with him. But I feel confident. Ow. Knockdown. Painful. Thankfully, I've got that stamina regeneration. Ow. Dodge out the doorway. At least that's one good thing about this stage, is that you can easily go through one of these doorways and bam, you're safe again. And you can reset and heal up as much as you want. Maybe I can get a bleed off this guy, but nah, I don't need it. Next swing here, and he's down. Excellent. And he drops humanity. Now, just looking at my timer and considering the time, I'm gonna have to fast forward for going to the blacksmith again. I'll leave this episode here, as we are just about to go down this waterfall. And when I come back, we'll finish off the depths and fight the gaping dragon. But for now, thank you for watching this episode of Dark Souls, and good hunting.